say that Oxendale gets the puck back. And here comes
what do you call a man who transforms skating skill into an ice ballet? What do you call a man who seemed to know what an opponent was going to do before he did it?
Gets away from Hextall. On the move. Bodior. Gets by Sather. Killing off the clock.
What do you call a man who played with supreme courage? What do you call a man who played for his teammates and his team, never for himself?
Back to Orr breaking. Orr.
What do you call a man who took an old game and remade it for a modern era? What do you call a man who redefined the meaning of grace under pressure?
Webster gets by Ron Harris. Orr's got the puck. Cuts through. Fires. Goal!
What do you call a man who now sits at the highest level among the heroes of hockey?
The open man is Sanderson. Takes the pass. Right in front. A quick goal by Bobby Orr.
What do you call a man who has become a legend in everybody's eyes but his own? You call him Bobby Orr. The boy from the small Ontario town who became a giant in the world's fastest, toughest game.
Bobby picks up speed as he swings the net. Gets by one man, ahead for Derek Sanderson. Bobby Orr back in the Boston zone on the loose puck. Kept in by the Chicago Blackhawks and Gotti. Runs right into Orr, and down he goes. Across to Orr. Orr shifts on Hogan. Back through, got here comes Orr. He's got running room. Pass to Esposito. Goal! It's 5-1. And Esposito has scored his second goal of the night, his 17th of the year. Bobby Orr picks up his second assist. Puck is loose. McKenzie has it. 45 seconds left to the penalty to Bergman. Orr fires. Goal! Corner by Cashman as the ball start up. Bobby Orr up to Hodge. Back to Orr. His shot. Time of Bobby's goal comes at 2:10.
Orr breaks out with Sanderson. 2-on-1. Reed is back. He's got Sanderson with him. Holds it to Sanderson. Back to Orr. Quick, empty net goal.
Russo. Ball out by New York here. Nobody in their net. Drive by Park goes wide. Orr. Long shot. And it scores.
Bobby Orr. To Sanderson. Going in. Sandy. Try goal. A great move by Sanderson.
To create something out of nothing. To see possibilities where others see only chaos. To make a stunning move that no one has ever made before, instinctively, perfectly. A move that brings a roar of appreciation from the crowd and a grunt of disbelief from an opponent. To do these things in the heat of battle, at intense speed, in the midst of flashing blades and bruising bodies, that is art raised to its highest level. Bobby Orr created within the game of hockey the way a Picasso or a Rembrandt created within a field of canvas. And the way we look at the world and the game has never been the same.
Hauled down by Barrett, in for Dusick, score! What a play by Dusick and Bobby Orr, who's caught on the ice.
I've got to see this one again to believe it. Now, you just watch Orr here and Dusick combined for this goal. Orr is down on the ice. Now, watch this play here. There's the puck. Now, here it comes. And there's Dusick cutting in from the left wing, doing what he did just a moment ago, but he caught Gilbert going halfway and he just tucked it between his pads.
Bobby gets around. Jim Peters still has it from the line. Goal! And that's the record breaker. Bobby Orr has broken the record for most goals in a season by a defenseman. His 22nd goal of the year.
Moves it around. Howe up to Sanderson. Back to Orr. All of a sudden, he's got running room. Getting around Harris. Moving in. Scores! It's 3-2, and Orr has scored a shorthanded goal, his 100th point. That's Bobby Orr's 100th point of the season. No other defenseman in the National Hockey League history has ever done it. Orr gets around Collins. He's got running room. Passes to Westfall. His shot. Goal! It's 4-0 Boston. A new record by Bobby Orr. He's eclipsed Phil Esposito's all-time assist record. And it's a standing ovation here at the Boston Garden for Bobby Orr.
Here's Orr at the blue line, holding it in to Phil Esposito. He says he scores! Phil Esposito beats younger brother Tony on a low shot.
With Ken Hodge and Wayne Cashman crashing the boards and opposing players, with Phil Esposito's uncanny hands and unmovable bulk creating mayhem in the slot, and with Bobby Orr providing the electricity, the power, it's small wonder the Bruins became an incredible scoring machine.
Off the stick of Phil Esposito, wide to the far side.
Esposito, Cashman, Hodge, Orr, and Dallas Smith for the Bruins. All set. Here's Don Earl.
And Orr takes the faceoff from Esposito. Sneaks by Nielsen. Throws it across.
In a five-season span, Orr and Esposito combined to surpass 100 points 10 times. Along the way, winning a total of 7 scoring titles.
But a key move by Esposito, Orr, and Hodge.
During that period, Phil Esposito also had 5 50-goal seasons, many of those markers set up by the incredible Bobby Orr.
Orr shifts on Lacroix and starts out through center ice. Lead pass, Sanderson going in.
Bobby made every Bruin a better player, and that's the mark of a genius. The Béliveaux have it, the Gretzkys have it, and then there was Bobby Orr.
To Bobby Orr. Shot, go!
When the ice chips had settled at the end of the regular season, Bobby Orr stood above his peers as the first ever defenseman to win the Art Ross Trophy for leading the league in scoring points with 120 on 33 goals and 87 assists. He also picked up the Hart Trophy as the league's most valuable player, along with his 3rd consecutive Norris Trophy and 4th straight All-Star nod. Then the playoffs started, and Bobby Orr moved another step closer to the Hall of Fame with a brilliant performance that culminated in the Bruins' first Stanley Cup in 29 years, and Bobby Orr's selection as the Conn Smythe Trophy winner. Robert Gordon Orr truly was the most valuable player in this remarkable playoff drive. In the quarterfinals, the Bruins pasted the New York Rangers 4-2.
Orr across the line, going in, shot, goal! And the Bruins lead it 1-0. Orr.
The semifinals against the Chicago Blackhawks were even more of a mismatch, with the Bruins soaring on Orr's superlative play, taking the series 4-0 and outscoring the Hawks by 10 goals.
Bobby Orr legs it back up through center ice.
And then in the final, it would be St. Louis's turn. And when he was with St. Louis, Terry Crisp had been touched by the Orr magic. Back in 1967, Harry Howell, a veteran New York Ranger defenseman, won the Norris Trophy as that year's best rearguard and said at the time, "I might as well enjoy it now because I expect it's going to belong to Bobby Orr for the next 10 years. Bobby did win the Norris for 8 straight years. And if his knees had stayed healthy, who knows, he might still be playing, thrilling crowds and setting records. He had that kind of intensity. The total love for the game that never wavers, never dies. How good was he? Well, it's been said that if you put 5 Orrs against 5 Howes or 5 Gretzkys, the Orrs would win hands down. Because Orr could play at both ends of the ice. He could handle the puck in the offensive zone like a centerman. He had a shot like a rocket from anywhere. He could score from the point, and he could play defense like a demon.
Bobby Orr's got it as he's doing a bit of fancy stick handling between the two blue lines. Look at him go.
And if the usual ways, the expected moves didn't work, he created his own, in his own style, in his own way. On the ice, Bobby Orr was unmistakable, and unmistakably the best.
122. Orr gets by Kelly. Across the line. Cuts in deep. Shot. Orr was almost upended as he cut it on Gamble. Busick controls. Gets it back to Orr. Orr cuts in. Stanfield in the corner. Right out front. But shot.
The Bruins won 57 games, tied 7, and lost only 14 as they captured the Eastern Division title in fine style. And Bobby Orr continued to raise the bar by rewriting the record book as he surged to NHL records for most assists in the regular season, 102, and most points in the regular season, 139, by a defenseman. He also won the Hart Trophy as the most valuable player in the league for a second straight year, along with a fourth Norris Trophy as the premier defenseman and his fifth All-Star berth.
Stolen by Delvecchio. Esposito has a four-man rush to Orr. He's over the line.
Esposito and Orr were an on-ice marriage made in hockey heaven. There have been other great backline to frontline combinations, Harvey and Béliveau, Coffey and Gretzky, Bork and Neely, but none as prolific, as downright awesome, as undeniably great as Orr and Esposito. But then Orr made every Bruin into a scoring threat, an assist leader. So up and down the Bruins roster in that memorable year, and look at the numbers for players like Derek Sanderson, Eddie Westfall, John McKenzie, Freddie Stanfield, the Chief, Johnny Busick, and the rest of that driven Bruins team, and you'll see what Orr meant to them all. He took them beyond themselves and into hockey history.
To Sanderson, now to Orr, breaking. Here comes Orr, right in. He shoots it. But now Orr breaks, delayed call. He's out to Walton. Go ahead for the net. Walton closes, fires, and misses. Rebound, score, Bobby Orr.
Now watch Bobby heading for the net. He's going to turn and come over to the right side just as Walton drives the puck. There he turns. Now watch this backhander. Right here at the top corner. How does he do it? I don't know.
Or controlling, wheeling, behind the net. A backhander! Esposito scores!
On the strength of Orr's superlative play, coupled to one of the most awesome offensive units ever seen in the NHL, the Bruins won the East Division with 119 points. Once again, Orr was the cream of the league, winning the Norris Trophy, the Hart Trophy, and his sixth consecutive All-Star selection. In the playoffs, Orr raised his exceptional game even higher, setting playoff records for assists and points by a defenseman, and capturing the Conn Smythe Trophy as the outstanding playoff performer, as he led the Bruins to their second Stanley Cup in 3 years.
O'Reilly for Orr to Shepherd, and they break. Shepherd on the right side for Orr. Flip pass, he may break in. He's in. One-hander, and it rolls in. Just popped the corner, a one-hand goal by Bobby Orr.
By now, even the most casual hockey fan knew the electricity that was Bobby Orr. Gearing up in his own end at the beginning of a nice long rush to glory that always showed a new dimension to his seemingly endless skills. Or diffusing a dangerous opposition rush with a casual flick of his stick, or a courageous headlong dive in front of a 90-mile-an-hour puck. For Bobby, there was only one way to play the game, and that was flat out all the time. And for those of us who saw him play, well, the usual fan's fantasy of imagining yourself out there on the ice making those moves, scoring those heroic goals, that didn't work with Bobby. He was just too good for our imaginations to contain.
Swoops in front. Nice shift over to Busick. Orr fights for it behind the net, has it, looking in front, wheels in front, locked on the pass, has it again, Orr cuts around, a backhander, scores off the post! Plant stops it behind the net for Orr, Orr with Gould there, tries it on an empty net, throws her out, and it is a score, a racket! He fired that from behind the goal line. I didn't see Crozier out of the net, but Orr did, and he didn't miss. Orr in by Clancy, scores right through the pads of Gordon McRae, and it's 1-1. Shorthanded, here he is, cutting in with Esposito, whipping on the side, and he scores! Bobby Orr, shorthanded goal to tie it up. What a Bobby Orr goal! Here comes Orr up the middle. Over the line, trying to go in. He does! He scores! What a goal for a hat trick! Bobby Orr, his 100th point!
Orr with a fantastic move. Bobby Orr can do it all. He's gotten three goals tonight for his 100th point.
Sanderson, Hodge, Busick, Stanfield, and Orr. Orr drives. Score! And a deflection of Ken Hodge. Orr is back. Park goes for the shot. Save. Gets the second one. What a stop by Bobby Orr! You've never seen anything like that. He covered behind Plant.
Brad Park got the original drive. He picked up his own rebound. Jock went down. Park drew it around him. He had the open net. You watch it here. Orr dived.
But in that almost season of 1972-73, Bobby's beloved Bruins didn't get to sip champagne from Lord Stanley's famous mug. And to Orr, personal honors were no replacement for team success.
Over to Orr, both clubs shorthanded. Orr over the line by Harris, moving, drives, scores, Bobby Orr!
Now starts out, gets by Bobby Hall, and now retreats again. 17 seconds. Fakes one way, goes to the left, wheels again, killing off the clock, 10 seconds left.
Orr starts it out, checked by Holmes.
By this point in his career, those special Bobby Orr moves were being recognized by fans and fellow stars alike.
Passes to Hodge, back to Orr, in tight, scores! It's 6-5.
So I went down for a morning skate, and there was Bobby Orr. I couldn't believe it. It was like when Sonny Fitzsimmons, the old horse trainer, saw Secretariat. He couldn't believe it. I looked at him. This was the ultimate in a hockey player. I never knew someday I was going to be lucky enough to coach him.
Don Cherry knew that he had a very special talent on his team, and like every hockey fan, he loved to watch that talent soar.
Allman a shot, Orr the save!
Now Esposito, Busick, Schmatz, the draw to Orr, turns, fires, scores!
Bobby Orr from Phil Esposito, just like that. The 251st for Orr, but his 38th goal this season, and that is a new record in the NHL, held formerly by Bobby Orr.
Sanderson out first time as Orr rushes.
Right inside, Marat, it is Orr in, one-hander, and a save, score, Kasman on the rebound.
Wilson looking at the empty net, the backhander blocked by Orr. Controlled again by Wilson, and that should do it. Another shot by Wilson, and a save by Orr with his stick. He just got a piece of Ellis, and I tell you, if he hits him, they'll feel it. Lead pass in for Orr, deflects to Orr, he's in, and he scores! Bobby Orr! With a break in on a deflected pass, moved in alone, and McRae drew him out and put in the backhander, and it's 1-0.
That one whistled wide. Orr for the Bruins, tied up by Ecclestone and Berenson. Westfall rolled it in front. Sanderson tried a shot that was wide, and Keenan cleared it but not out. Bobby Orr behind the net to Sanderson. Orr! Bobby Orr!